Well, what's up, everybody?
Welcome
to another Victory Group. I'm so glad. We are so glad that you are in group. And we just want to say thank you for being faithful to group like you've been. And if you're brand new, welcome to group, man. Whoever invited you really did a favor in blessing you. You're going to enjoy yourself today. I promise you that. And so let's open in prayer quickly. Father, we bless you. We honor you. We love you, Lord. We magnify you. We thank you for this time together. Bless this time. Bless each person as part of our group now. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's dive in. We've been in a phenomenal teaching, brand new, that we just started, entitled Standing Strong, Strength for Living. And it has been really good. We've got the great run, and it's been really, really good. And I hope that you've been getting a lot out of it. If you haven't heard it, you're new, then you will get some stuff even starting today. You need to go back and check out the last few lessons.
Yes.
But one of the things we said with this Strength for Living series, we're not talking about physical strength or emotional strength. We're talking about this spiritual strength.
Yes.
Inner strength that comes directly from the Spirit
of
God.
Which then gives us strength for those other areas.
Yeah. And one of the things we said is there's a big difference between still standing and standing strong.
Yes.
Still standing means, you know, you're barely making it. Mm-hmm. You're barely making it, man. You're just making it through. But standing strong means I'm overcoming.
Yes.
I'm dominating. I'm walking in victory.
In the midst.
No matter what I'm facing.
No matter what.
I'm dominating. And so if you don't remember, we said that standing strong is simply this. Let's reinforce our definition. Here's the definition for standing strong.
Yeah, we said that standing strong is having the spiritual ability of power, prominence of character to resist what needs to be resisted, and the wherewithal to endure and accomplish the predetermined objective of advancing the kingdom of God.
And that's the key, that no matter what I'm facing, no matter what I'm overcoming, no matter what I'm dealing with, that I have the wherewithal to overcome it, overthrow it, and advance the kingdom of God in that situation.
And that's the purpose,
I don't think people realize many times that everything we face is an opportunity to advance the kingdom.
Amen.
You know, being an example, being a testimony, showing people how to walk by faith. And so this whole thing about standing strong is a life application. And no matter what you're facing, you do have the wherewithal to overcome it and continue advancing the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Now, here's the thing that we've been really looking at, and that is understanding, you know, really this strength for standing strong. You know, it's impacted by what? What did we say? Go ahead and read that.
We said that becoming spiritually strong and being able to stand strong to the degree that we develop a resourceful relationship with the Holy Spirit.
That's so important, that you and I will stand strong to the degree that we develop this intimate, resourceful relationship with the Holy Spirit. That you can't stand strong without Him because that inner strength comes from Him.
Yes.
Comes from the Holy Spirit. That's the key, that this strength, this inner strength, not physical, not emotional, comes from your time that you spend with the Holy Spirit. And as Pastor Aisha just said, to the degree that you spend time with the Holy Spirit, develop your relationship with the Holy Spirit will be the degree that you truly stand strong.
And I think that's so important, because many times when we're going through situations or circumstances, it can be easy for us to get in a situation and react versus
respond
versus react according to the Word of God. But when you have the Holy Spirit and you have an intimate relationship with the Holy Spirit, you're really cautious and more sensitive as to how the Holy Spirit would have you to respond.
And intentional.
And intentional.
Intentional.
And the Holy Spirit, the main purpose of the Holy Spirit's job is to bring back to remembrance what the Word of God says. And so you're really cautious of, okay, well, what would God have me to do in this situation? And every situation and every circumstance that we would ever face, many times God has a solution in the Word.
Yes.
So the Holy Spirit will bring back to our remembrance what we need to know, when we needed to know it, at whatever point of time we need to know it, according many times to the Word of God, so we can handle and stand strong in any situation.
And so that leads us into, you know, knowing the Holy Spirit is in our lives for a few specific things.
Yes.
You're really on it. Let's kind of go through that. Number one, we said the Holy Spirit is in our lives for what?
Transformation.
For transformation.
Yes.
We reinforce that the Holy Spirit, the day you got born again, the Bible says the Holy Spirit breathes on your life.
Amen.
And imparts this Zoe life, the Bible says. And we said the Zoe life is the life is the Greek word Zoe. And it means the God kind of life, the God nature is what it means. And so the Holy Spirit is in our lives for transformation, that we go from being unsaved and not being born again to being born again and getting going from that old sinful nature to that new nature of God, the Zoe life on the inside.
Yeah, and I think that's important because God says that he'll be perfecting us until the day Jesus Christ returns. Yeah. It's not like when you get saved and all of a sudden you know it all and you've arrived. No, you are learning how to walk this walk. You're learning how to stand strong, and that's the purpose too of the Holy Spirit to help to perfect us as we walk this walk.
And so foundationally, because that walk starts from, you got this God nature in you.
Yeah.
But now the Holy Spirit, the second function that he does, the second thing we get is what? Because it ties right to it.
Revelation.
That he's in our life for revelation, and that the Holy Spirit now needs you to get revelation about what's inside of you and who you become.
Yes.
You go from being this unsaved that is saved, but really getting understanding now that is being born again. We found out from the lessons a few weeks ago that one, I'm the righteousness of God.
Yes.
I'm the righteousness of God. That's who I am.
Mm-hmm.
That you're not just a believer. You're the righteousness of God. You're in right standing with God. But then the second thing that I think
No, but I want to, when you talk about revelation, like I said earlier, that the Holy Spirit's job too is to bring back to remembrance of what we need to know so we know how to apply it.
Right.
But many times it's that revelation that we need on how to really apply that word in the situation that we may find ourselves in as well, because you know the word is the word, but how do we apply that word to whatever situation we're in at that time, which is the revelation, so that we can truly stand strong.
And applying that word from who you are as the righteousness of God. I'm the righteousness of God, and I have a right to apply this word and a right to expect this word to come to pass. But we found out also not only just of who we are, but the second thing the Holy Spirit wants to give us revelation on is what?
What we're capable of.
What you're capable of. And that is, we found that you're capable, according to scripture, of upholding the judgment of God. That God has passed judgment in the earth. He's already judged the enemy. And you and I have the ability, we're capable of,
and the authority.
And the authority, yes, to uphold the judgment of God and to reinforce the sentence that has already been passed in that situation. And so not only is the Holy Spirit in our lives for, you know, for transformation, for revelation, but the other thing we looked at is what?
Celebration.
Celebration. He's in it. Celebrate good times.
Come on.
You know, he's really in our life for celebration. That, you know, there's so much benefit for us concerning the Holy Spirit and who we are and what we become, that we're there. It's a celebration of the Holy Spirit in our lives. The Holy Spirit doesn't want to sit by and casually walk with you. He wants to turn around and be daily, a daily help with you. And there's a celebration that comes with that. Now, as we're closing out, we said this is the thing, because you can hear about the Holy Spirit and so forth, and you're just waiting for something to happen. But one of the things we talked about in one of the lessons was, you know, really concerning the supernatural move of God is what?
We said that the supernatural move of God in your life is waiting on your response to the call of God to do what you have not ever done before.
You're not waiting on a move of God. The move of God is waiting on you.
Amen.
Waiting on you for your response to the call of God, response to what what God wants to do.
I was singing that song, waiting on you.
Yeah. You know, and it's so true. I'm not going to do that.
No.
And so, you know, you got to understand that the supernatural move of God is waiting on your response. And,
Amen.
You know, we talked about our response lately, because you can have a variety of responses and most of them are wrong. We said, number one, you can have what type of response?
A reserve response.
Where you go, nah, I'll think about it, but not now. Paul was preaching to King Agrippa, and King Agrippa said, you almost persuaded me, but not right now. So maybe you have a reserved response. Number two is what?
Well, you could have a rejected response.
A rejected response. We looked in Mark chapter 10, the rich young ruler, Jesus is ministering to him, trying to give him an opportunity for quality of life, and he rejected. He's like, nope, and he walked away grieved. You could turn around and just flat out reject mm-hmm. what the Holy Spirit wants to yeah. do. You know, just reject it. I'm not gonna get caught up in the Holy Spirit. I don't believe in that. You could be past reserve a rejected response. Or number three is what?
Or you could have a resentful response.
A resentful response that, you know, well, things aren't happening the way you want. You know, you got this expectation of some spooky, goofy thing concerning the Holy Spirit. And because it's not like that, there's this resentful response. And we talked about in 2 Kings with Naaman, who goes to the prophet. He needs healing. He has leprosy. And the prophet gives him directions that went against Naaman's expectation.
Yeah.
He thought the prophet was going to lay hands on him and go be healed. And the prophet said, go dip yourself in the Jordan 7 times.
I told you we should write a book on that, on expectations.
Yeah.
You know, but even when you think about that, God says his ways aren't our ways, his thoughts aren't our thoughts. So 9 times out of 10, it ain't going to happen the way you think or when you think it should happen anyway. Yeah. So I don't know why we get in that mindset that we think something's going to happen a certain way or in a certain time frame, because God even talks about that in his word that 9 times out of 10, it ain't going to happen that way.
Yeah. So you could have a resentful response to the mm-hmm. Holy Spirit because of something didn't go down the way you thought it was going to go down in the past. And now you're just like, I'm not even going to think about the Holy Spirit because God hasn't come through for mm-hmm. me, or things didn't work out the way I was believing. Sometimes, a lot of times, many times, things don't work out the way you thought they would, but they work out the way they needed to work out.
Yes, and that doesn't mean they didn't work out. Yeah. It just didn't work out the way you thought it should have worked
out. So you could have a reserve response, a rejected response, a resentful response, but you really want to have this type of response, and that's
And that's a ready response.
A ready response. And we reinforced in Mark chapter 10, blind Bartimaeus man, Jesus is walking by, and he's calling on Jesus. Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. And Jesus stopped and said, come. And blind Bartimaeus was ready mm-hmm. with a response to come. You and I have to be ready mm-hmm. with a response of, here I am, Lord, use me. You got to be ready for the Holy Spirit to flow through you. That should be your expectation.
Come on, let us hear you say, I'm ready. I'm ready.
Come on, everybody in the room. I'm ready for what the Holy Spirit wants to do in my life. And that ready response allows now the Holy Spirit to respond to your expectation and do what your eyes haven't seen, your ears haven't heard, what has not even entered into your heart yet, the things that God has planned for you.
Amen.
Well, this has been very good. This is just a little clip, man, of this series. And so if you haven't seen any of it, you're missing it. Yes. You need to go back and check it out. Okay, go back and check it out because there's a lot of meat in it. All right, here's our question mm-hmm. for today in small group. So here's our question. It'll come up on the screen. But with this series, this is what we want you to think about today. Go. What's our question?
With everything that we've talked about today, we want to know, how does your relationship with the Holy Spirit need to change for you to be able to truly stand strong?
So we're talking about the Holy Spirit is the key. He is the source of your strength. To the degree that you have this intimate relationship with him is a degree that you're going to spiritually stand strong. So with that in mind, honestly now, don't be deep. How does your relationship with the Holy Spirit need to change for you to be able to truly stand strong?
Yes.
Amen and amen. Amen. All right. Well, listen, there's a lot of stuff going on. Stay connected to the website. Stay connected to all of our social media platforms. And today in group, have a great time. If there's anybody new, pounce on them in a good way. Love on them. Everybody involved, have a great time in fellowship today. Mm-hmm. Build some relationship because we are always and truly what?
Better and stronger together.
Well, we got to go, man. We love y'all so very much. Mm-hmm. Can't wait to see you in service. If you haven't been back to the building yet, what you waiting on? Come on, let's go. Mm-hmm. We want to see your face in the place. But we always close this way. No matter where you look, up, down, in, out, wherever, there's victory only one place in the entire universe. Where is that, Mama?
That's in Christ Jesus.
Be blessed.
Be blessed.